Hello students, in the previous session we have discussed a little about the poem Why I Am Not a Painter. We have learned what the poet Frank O'Hara wants to show us through the poem. Poetry and painting, though these two are different art forms, yet they have some similarities. So this is the main idea of the poem. We know that there are two characters in the poem. One is the painter Mike Goldberg and another is the poet himself, Frank O'Hara himself. And we know that both of them are friends. So now let's begin, let's start reading and understanding the poem. I am not a painter, I am a poet. Why? I think I would rather be a painter, but I am not. So students, in the very beginning of the poem, the poet Frank O'Hara says that he wishes to be a painter. But he says that he is a poet and not a painter. So at the very beginning of the poet Frank O'Hara shows us, or he makes us believe, that poetry and painting are not the same. They are different from each other, as he says that he himself is a poet and not a painter. Well, for instance, Mike Goldberg is starting a painting. I drop in. Sit down and have a drink, he says. I drink. We drink. I look up. You have sardines in it. Yes, it needed something there. So students, now the poet Frank O'Hara goes on to talk about his painter friend Mike Goldberg, right? So the poet says that one day he went to his painter friend Mike Goldberg's place and both of them drink something. It could be a cup of tea or coffee or whatever you want to think, as it is not mentioned here. And then the poet Frank O'Hara looked up and saw the half-made painting of his friend Mike Goldberg. Mike Goldberg was about to start his painting and the word sardines, S-A-R-D-I-N-E-S, the word sardines was written on it. The poet, that is why, asked the painter friend that you have sardines in it. And Mike Goldberg replies that yes, there needs to be something. It needed something there. So students, the poet Frank O'Hara thinks that his painter friend Mike Goldberg was going to paint something, something related to sardines. As the word sardines, S-A-R-D-I-N-E-S, was written on it. So the word sardines, S-A-R-D-I-N-E-S, the word sardines itself gave the poet an idea or an image that what his friend painter Mike Goldberg must have been thinking to paint. So the word sardines itself gives the poet Frank O'Hara an idea or an image of what the painter or his friend Mike Goldberg was about to paint. Now, oh, I go and the days go by and I drop in again. The painting is going on and I go and the days go by. I drop in. The painting is finished. So students, now the poet Frank O'Hara says that he kept visiting his friend Mike Goldberg's place and he used to see the painting going on. Means his painter friend Mike Goldberg keeps on painting the canvas. Every time the poet O'Hara visited his friend's place, every time he saw the painter friend painting, means the painting is taking time to get completed. It is also taking the painter's effort, and that is why it was not made in a day. It took time. It took the painter's effort, and that is why the poet says that I go and the days go by. I go and the days go by and I drop in again. The painting is going on and I go and the days go by. So students, the painting took time and effort to get completed, right? Now, I drop in, the painting is finished. Where is sardines? All that is left is just letters. It was too much, Mike says. So now students, again, one day when the poet O'Hara visited his friend Mike Goldberg's place, he says that he saw that the painting is finished. He saw that the painting has been completed. Mike Goldberg completed creating his painting. But the poet Frank O'Hara saw that in the painting there were no sardines painted or drawn on it. And that is why he asks his painter friend that where is sardines? Means he asks that, okay, you have finished your painting. You were about to paint the sardines. But where is the sardines now? So there was no image of sardines painted on it. So what was there in the painting was the only letters, S-A-R-D-I-N-E-S. Those were the letters which were there, which were only there in the painting. So which he just somewhat colored. Okay, so and the painter replies by saying that it was too much. So students, this stanza of the poem shows the creating process of Mike Goldberg, which he uses to make his painting. He was inspired by the word sardines. He goes on painting, taking that word in his mind, but he does not make the painting more complicated by drawing something related to sardines. He simply goes on painting. It takes time and effort, and one day he completed his painting, and the painting had only the letters. And now what are the letters? The painting only and the painting had only the letters S-A-R-D-I-N-E-S, sardines, and not an image or picture of it. It had not a picture, not a single picture of sardines. Sardines means small fishes, as I have already told you. So there was no picture or no image of actual sardines he painted, but there were only the letters in the letters on the painting, and these letters were S-A-R-D-I-N-E-S, sardines, but there was no image of actual sardines in the painting. Now, but me, one day I am thinking of a color, orange. I write a line about orange. Pretty soon it is a whole page of words, not lines. Then another page. There should be so much more, not of orange, of words, of how terrible orange is and life. So students, now the poet Frank O'Hara comes to the next stanza, okay, and focuses on himself as a poet. He says that one day he starts thinking of the color orange. He had the image of orange color in his mind, and then he starts writing about the color. He keeps on writing, he goes writing and writing, and at a point of time, it is a whole page of words. It becomes a whole page of words. He keeps on writing whatever he could by taking the image of the orange color in his mind. Now, days go by. It is even in prose. I am a real poet. My poem is finished and I haven't mentioned orange yet. So students, now again, we are introduced with the poet O'Hara's creative process, okay? In the first stanza, in the above stanza, we looked at the creating process of used by Mike Goldberg, the painter. And now in the second stanza, Frank O'Hara wants to show us his creative process, okay? So first of all, he thinks of the image of orange color. and starts writing. Days go by. So this job of writing something, this job of writing a poem or whatever he was writing, also took time and effort. He was inspired by the word or the color image. He keeps on writing, and one day he finished writing and he says that whatever he wrote till now, by thinking of the orange color in his mind, whatever he wrote till now did not directly mention the word orange, O-R-A-N-G-E. He thought about the orange color, he wrote about the orange color, but inside the poems, he did not directly mention the word orange, O-R-A-N-G, inside what he wrote. Now, it's 12 poems, I call it oranges, and one day in a gallery, I see Mike's painting called Sardines. So students, now the poet O'Hara says that once he finished writing, he found out that he wrote 12 poems. Okay, and he named them or called the whole collection of these 12 poems as oranges, which you can see here. This is the name he had given to his combination of 12 poems. But he did not mention the word orange in any of his poem, although he wrote all of them taking the image of orange color in his mind, but he did not mention the word orange in any of his poem. He thought of orange color, he wrote about orange color, but he did not mention the word orange. He did not directly mention the word orange inside what he wrote. So people cannot see the word orange in his 12 poems, but they can get to know that the poet had the image of orange color, or he must have thought about the word orange while writing the poems. And the name gives the people the idea or the image of the orange color. So the poet says that he called his combination of 12 poems as oranges. And one day, in an art gallery, the poet Frank O'Hara saw the painting of his friend Mike Goldberg, which was named as Sardines, S-A-R-D-I-N-E-S. Means the painter Mike Goldberg named his painting Sardines. Okay. So students, this is the end of the poem. We get to know that the poet Frank O'Hara shows the similarities between two different art forms, that is between poetry and painting, and there is a similarity in both their process of creating art. The painter and the poet both get inspired by two particular words, sardines and oranges, and they start creating their work. It takes time and effort, and finally they produce their poetry and painting. The painting was named as Sardines, but did not have anything related to sardines painted on it. The letters or the word sardines, S-A-R-D-I-N-E-S, these letters or this word could give the viewers or people an idea or an image of what the painter wants to show us through his painting. And similarly, the poetry produced by the poet Frank O'Hara was also a combination of 12 poems, and he named it Oranges. Okay, but even though the poems are named as oranges, they did not directly mention the word orange in them, right? The word oranges could give the viewers or the readers the word oranges could give the viewers an image, or by reading the poem or the words of the poems, the reader or the people can have an idea of what the poet must have thought about at that time of writing. So we know that the painter Mike Goldberg converted the letters sardines, S-A-R-D-I-N-E-S, into an image, right? Similarly, the poet Frank O'Hara also converted the image of orange color, which he had in his mind. He converted this image of orange color into words. He wrote about that color. So that is how the poet Frank O'Hara showed us the similarities between two different art forms, that is between poetry and painting. So students, I hope you have understood the poem well, and if you have any doubt, kindly ask me over WhatsApp. I will provide you with the question answers of the poem in the WhatsApp group.